Welcome everybody to our webinar, Boost Your Lessons, Create a Podcast. This webinar is led by Hernán Moheno, a podcaster who's based in the state of Puebla in Mexico. I'm Rosalia Valero, and I'm very happy to see so many of you today. Thanks for accepting our invitation to help celebrate all teachers wherever they are.
Thank you, Rosalia. Welcome everybody. Let me introduce myself again. My name is Hernán Moheno, and I'm delighted to be here today. First of all, I would like to thank you all attendees in this webinar. Believe me, I'm privileged to be here today. And I have to say that Cambridge continues sharing these great events for teachers. And it's amazing. It's just amazing to be here today. Now, let's get started with this, all right? So first things first, let's quickly see what this webinar is about. Let's have this overview. What's a podcast? It's important to be clear on what a podcast is. I'm sure some of you have heard about it. So I hope you help me with your ideas, and then I'll give you my definition. After that, I'll present you a couple of platforms that can work out for the creation of your podcast and some instructions to start with. Then I'll specify the reasons why a podcast can be that asset you should try for your English lessons and get the best of it. Last but not least, I'll share all the activities I have done and I'm about to, so everybody can try them at home. All right, let's go. What's a podcast? Let's see, I have my own definition and I know it can be very similar to the ones you have, but what if you want to define it with one word only? Could you do that? If so, please be kind to go to the to menti.com and enter the code I'm displaying. In one word, tell me what you think a podcast is. All right. So now I can see what you are writing in here. So we have communication, of course. You have audio, recording, radio show, documentary, speech. Thank you. Let's wait a little bit more to get more options here. All right. Look at this. Knowledge, of course. Entertainment, absolutely. An audio tool, social, yes. Voice, tool, ideas, share ideas, chat. Speech. All right, mostly audio, right? Audio communication and recording. Thank you very much. Let's continue with the presentation. Such a great number of results, by the way. I truly appreciate your participation. All right, my definition of a podcast is the following. An audio show split in a series of episodes, which can be downloaded from the internet and listened to on our smartphones. You subscribe to shows and you'll have an episode every time they are meant to be posted on platforms such as Spotify, iTunes, iVoox, Deezer, Himalaya, Anchor, and so many others. That's the thing. All right. Let's talk about the characteristics. Now, I can tell you that there are so many topics out there. So I would like to start speaking about podcasts in general. Having said that, we have to be aware that topics are so different among them. So you find art, news, and science podcasts on one side, and podcasts of anecdotes, pets, books, reviews, this other side. There is also room for podcasts dedicated to teach English and all the topics you can think of. Another characteristic is the duration. This depends on the creators, also called podcasters. There are 1 minute podcasts out there, as well as 3 or 4 hour long ones too. In my experience as an English teacher, I must say my podcasts are no longer than 20 minutes for large classes and 10 for small ones. The thing is that once you start making podcasts with students, they want to try something new every audio file. Of course, at first they reject the idea, but trust me when I say that certain feelings change and turn to excitement and collaboration when they see the result. Okay, some podcasts start with music. Some others start straight to discussing a particular topic. Some others are made of segments, and the rest just go with the flow. In some occasions, we have some audios from radio programs and TV shows, which have been taken out and converted to podcasts, so they follow their established structure. For the ones that I have monitored, because I like to be aware of new shows, I can tell you that there are more like interviews and anecdotes of a celebrity or experts in a specific area. They just talk, and it's a new thing to enjoy with all of these programs. To finish with these features, I would say that podcast providers have players. I mean, music players with special features different than regular players that we have on our cell phones, computers, and so on. For instance, Spotify allows you to rewind 15 seconds to catch what you missed or to listen to the beginning of an idea. Some other players allow you to increase speed, decrease it as well. This is something I have taken advantage to, and my students agree that this is an attribute for developing their listening skills. There's a group of podcast players that share transcripts and promote collaboration. Those are the ones we will talk about today. Now, teachers, I think there's a valid argument here when I say that apps are there for us to use. I mean, let's give them a try. Today, many of us are adapting our strategies to teach English online, but there's a long way to go with new alternatives. This is the case of the apps I'm about to show you. Okay, suggested platforms and the making of. Okay, great, let's jump into making our first podcast. Are you excited? I hope you are. Now for this, a smartphone and an internet connection are required to download one of these two apps, Anchor and Soundtrack. I consider these two as the best ones because they are very, and I say very, user-friendly in the process of making your podcast. I'll explain myself better in a minute. Right, the first app is Anchor. It's available for iOS and Android. Once you have installed it, just run it to log in. Use your email account you have assigned for your classes. If you're using another one, you will have to fill in some spaces with your information, but I think that's not a problem. I personally use it and I have had no problems at all. Here I'm displaying a short video with the first steps. And I made some other ones, so stay tuned because at the end of the presentation, you'll be able to download them. After this, after following all this procedure, you're going to be in. Okay. Great. Let's jump into making this real, right? Okay. Of course, there are some things you need to consider. For example, from here, I mean, you have to give some permissions to your device to turn on the microphone, okay? And then you're gonna be able to record your podcast. The process, as I said, and I repeat, is absolutely easy. You tap on the plus symbol to start adding audios to your first episode. You have to speak into the microphone of your device after giving permissions to the app. Suggestions. Before doing this, you can try writing a script to read towards your smartphone, so you don't lose track of the words or instructions you want to record. I totally recommend you to be in a quiet place because microphone sensitivity varies. And I'm sure you want to have a clean, strong voice for your students to listen. Okay, you can start with your introduction first and stop the recording. The next step is to add music in the background. Just like in the video, right now, I'm showing you that this app allows you to have some, you know, chunks of music. They are absolutely for free and you do not get in troubles with any copyright situations, anything like that. Everything is for free. So that's a good thing. So you can start with this. You can try all the options that are there. And of course, you can listen to the result. What's the best thing about this app? Well, you can continue recording audios and they become segments. So in case you need to correct something or there's another important thing to do, you can resume the project later on. This is great, teachers, because once we are planning to create such a nice thing as a podcast, sometimes your ideas are not clear or you don't feel satisfied with the audios you create at first. So you can erase them, you can trim them, you can edit them, you can add this music, I'm telling you. And one of the things I consider is also important is that you will have time to do it. So it doesn't have to be like just one time to do it, this 20 or 30 minutes or the duration you prefer. And if this wasn't enough, teachers, you can also invite your students to collaborate on this open project. You send them an invitation and they'll be redirected to download the app, create their accounts, and basically they'll be part of the podcast. There are different ways to make them part of this. And I think the creators of this app realize the need people have nowadays. Here's the thing, okay. Now, when the project is done, and all your students have submitted their contributions, you can listen to the final version on the app, which I think it's enough for your lessons. Now, I have the microphone open and I have my smart device with me. Here I have an example of things that you can do with your, in this case, students. Don't forget that they need to download the app. And of course, you send them an invitation through a link. And in that way, you will see that the way that it is connected is just like having a telephone conversation and everything is recorded. So probably before starting with this, you can tell your students what to do, to follow the script, or like just prepare them. That's what I would say. Now I'm gonna just place the speaker next to the microphone and let's see if you can catch this.
Hello, Andrea. I was just wondering if we can create this podcast together.
Yes, of course.
I'll be glad to listen to all your ideas for the new podcast.
All right.
Thank you.
Okay. Sorry for the echo in the background, but this is because we are at home and I was just trying to have this example for you guys. All right. Now, your students will be delighted to listen to themselves and their partners. They will witness the making of a file that can represent the beginning of many others. And who knows, maybe they like this and find making a podcast a way to communicate with the world. Don't forget to ask for permissions to parents if your students are underage, so they are aware their children are working on this and you are responsible for the content of this podcast. If they are adults, of course, you need to ask for permission as well, so they are aware of what's going on with their voices and of course their contributions. Okay, let's move on to the next slide. This is the other app called Soundtrap. The very important thing you must know about it is that it works way better in its web version. The app for devices is okay, but you have the comfort and full view of your projects on a window of your browser. Soundtrap is here, and just like Anchor, you have to create or link an account to get in. What you see here is the profile I use for my lessons. And I have to say that it is more colorful than Anchor. That could be a hook for your students to stay. And of course, press the buttons to see what happens next. I believe that this is so friendly. There's a disclaimer, teachers. So far, it sounds like I'm running a tutorial in this webinar and there are some missing parts to explain this properly. The thing is that I'll share real tutorials with you, and this is just a short version of what you can do. I also have to say that I'm still discovering new things, and I'll be glad to discover more next to you. So I know you are scared and a bit skeptical, but I know you'll be amazed with your students' results after checking these tools. I'm not tiring myself of telling this. Believe me, this is so great. And I'm telling you, I mean, my students appreciate all of this. Okay, so let's move on to check a little bit of the web version. Okay, so in this case, you need to go to soundtrap.com, and click on the upper right part of the page where it says education. Now, we have to remember that we have regular versions for musicians or storytelling teachers or so on, but Soundtrap has a special place for us as teachers, and I'll show you why in a minute. Select to start as a teacher. Register with your email from Google or other email services you have, and you'll have a 90-day free trial with full features included. After this period, you'll be able to continue using your account, and believe me when I say that you won't necessarily need all the attributes to create your podcast. Those are more for music creators. Once you are in, a set of tutorials will be displayed on the screen. If you want, you can watch them or just click on create a project. Then you select the option podcast and set the microphone when you hit the record button to start recording yourself. Here you can consider some technical things such as having an external microphone, test it, and so on. Nothing to be worried about, teachers. You can create new tracks below yours, and then you'll be ready to share this project with your students. The best thing about this app is that you can link this account with Google Classroom, as well as Microsoft Teams, Canva, and so many others. In that way, you will have your students' emails. So you can invite them to be part of the project you create. And the easiest thing is to get all emails from all their emails from Google Classroom. And that's what you do. They can record their parts and you can monitor their performance. I wasn't able to try last time I was teaching these students on the video, but you are also able, as far as I know, to see in real time what they are doing. There's also a chance to have a chat next to the project. So in case they have questions, in case they got, you know, if they struggle with the application, they can contact you. And of course, now we will have two people struggling in this application. Okay, let me tell you that when you share the project through Google Classroom, the activity is created as a link and also be posted as an activity. So you as a teacher, don't use, in case you don't use Classroom or Microsoft Teams, there is also a chance to share a link so they can access to the platform that way. For a more detailed explanation and sources, please check the final part of this presentation. Okay. Wow, that was a long explanation, don't you think? Let's stop for a moment with the tutorials and let's discuss the reasons for using these two. Why a podcast, teachers? Why do we have to pass through all of this, I wonder? I make this question to myself because with all the alternatives out there, such as Kahoot, Quizlet, lyrics training, quizzes, Jeopardies, and so on and so forth, why in the world should I consider this as an element to use in my lessons? Here are some reasons I got after reflection. First, if you want to use a podcast to inform your students about anything, there is a high chance you create the task with clear instructions. You have to be specific so they don't find it hard to understand. Remember that there is no other element that can convey meaning. There is not an image, body language, or a specific sound at first. So, a script is required. And if you don't have that, I'm sure that you will be reading some instructions from the book or the ones you know by heart. This is not just for you, teacher, but for your students when they are required to add their contributions to the podcast. For example, your instructions are, and this is like you recording yourself towards your telephone, repeat the words on page 62 with the audio from the book. Then make sentences with the same words. Record yourself. There will be a number of students that want to record themselves properly, and this can lead to write their sentences first and read them after. I am not sure if many of them will record an audio producing sentences by heart. They want to make sure they sound correctly, and that's when you realize they wrote the sentences first. So many others will be like this, arguing to themselves if they are doing it correctly, or probably there was, you know, a dog barking in the background. So you will notice that after several repetitions, they got it. Listening comprehension, teachers, becomes the first thing to keep an eye on. I'm sure you'll have students asking for more details or simply letting you know the message was clear. Some others won't say a word, unfortunately, but you'll detect a low performance after this. Second, so you deal with a large class and there is not enough time to assess everybody speaking. Okay, try this. Record a task for specific students. They can work later on what to say. Then it can be part of an extra activity that won't take longer than a few minutes. And for you, it'll be like a voice note on WhatsApp. Suggestions. Set deadlines for that and delegate these to students who have demonstrated higher levels of comprehension. They will inform you their thoughts and nobody will feel ashamed about it. You can talk privately with your students in order to give feedback. Third, do your students struggle with confidence when they have to speak in your lessons? Well, making podcasts can help them to participate without being fully exposed. You can always talk to them privately, as I said before, and encourage them to continue recording themselves. At first, not an easy task, but then they receive good comments from you and your partners, or when they see their sound effects you add, or probably you are working with new techniques in order to record yourself, the things can change for them. I'm sure they will gain confidence with the activities I'm about to share, by the way. Fourth, time has passed and you are making podcasts now. You are an expert. So you ask your students to answer your questions about the topic of your lessons, previous exercises, to give their opinions about something, to tell you their plans after schools, etc., etc. But teachers consider to assign them different podcasts that can be part of your lesson. I'm talking about the ones BBC posts. You are watching this on your screen. Most of them are related to the news, historical events, and stories. So you can find a famous actor reading a book as well. And this can be an opportunity to discover the classics. For instance, The Brief Wondrous Life of Oscar Wilde by Juno Diaz, narrated by Lin-Manuel Miranda and Karen Olivo. What about The Handmaid's Tale by Margaret Atwood, narrated by Clary Danes? Or The Adventures of Tom Sawyer by Mark Twain, narrated by Nick Offerman. Think about it, teacher. There are so many resources out there. Instead of sharing a PDF file that you own, but it is hard to follow, you can open a new way to learn with these audios. your students can have extra material, such as transcripts, in case they don't get it at first. And according to research, let me tell you this, their brains activate the same areas they were reading, like if they were reading an actual book. This is according to a study published in the Journal of Neuroscience. Researchers from the Gallen Lab at UC Berkeley scanned the brains of 9 participants while they read and listened to a series of tales. And after analyzing how each word was processed in the brain's cortex, they created maps of the participants' brains. These are the ones that I'm displaying right now. They noticed the different areas that help interpret the meaning of each word. They found the semantic similarities during listening and reading. I'll share this information too. No worries, teachers. Okay. Another reason why a podcast is a nice thing to use, a nice tool to use, peer evaluation. And I say, peer evaluation in an audio? Why not? Set the rules for this. Teach your students to be kind and supportive, to point out their partner's mistakes. If you detect camaraderie among them, this can help you to save time in your lessons and give them the chance to do it again. So they will go back and check their listenings and they can see what the mistakes that they got. Self-correction is another option, teachers. By sending them a note, it can be a written one or it can be another audio, they can change their own audios, as I said. I think it's faster than if they were waiting for you to have a face-to-face meeting to receive feedback. Don't waste your time on Zoom or any other platforms doing that. Why don't you just encourage them to correct themselves? I think that would save a lot of time, and at the same time, they will become aware of their own mistakes. And isn't that what we want? That they can work on their own on something? I'm just asking you, teachers. Thank you. All right. So here's the thing, teachers. Oh, yes. Here we are, and we are happy to get to this place. Activities for teaching English, of course, with a podcast. I'd like to share all the ideas and files I put together for you to practice. You can follow my advice or go straight and try this amazing tool on your own. The best thing I can offer today is to encourage you to try this for once. Are you ready, teachers? I hope you are. Let's go. Create a podcast with questions related to your previous lesson. I previously mentioned this, I know, but there are more details on this. Assign these questions to some students in particular. It's not for all. You can assign later some other tasks to others. Set deadlines for this. When all your students have participated, add extra comments to the podcast so they continue with the conversation. In the following lessons, they can do this, so their answers are not isolated ones. Let me show you how. Here I have an audio, and let me tell you that I'm about to play something on Soundtrap. So the first audio that you were able to listen was from Anchor, and this one is from Soundtrap. I have my smart device with me. You are able to open it, as I said before, like in your app. It's not the same, let me tell you, but it works. So I'm about to play this in a second because it's loading the project. Okay, here it is. And are you ready? Here we go.
Welcome to today's podcast that is brought to you by Chiles La Güera. Thank you for that delicious flavor. Now, in this pro podcast, my today's guests are absolutely invited to give their opinions about the buildings in the countries that, of course, they are from. Now, let me introduce them for this edition of the podcast. First of all, let me say welcome to Ana Conde. Thank you to Jesus Barbosa, the same as his brother. Could you describe some examples of attractive or interesting buildings near?
Well, Puebla is a city known by its colonial architecture, so it has many religious buildings, and definitely one of the icons of my city is the cathedral. It started to build between 1536 and 1539. The cathedral was named Cultural Heritage of Humanity, and nowadays is the second cathedral biggest in Mexico.
This one is for you, Jesus and Daniel. What building in your country would you describe as a national treasure? I would like to hear an explanation of why that is important.
Well, teacher, that's a very difficult question.
Yeah.
In Mexico, we have many important buildings, so it's hard to choose just one. But as my friend Jesus just mentioned, the Pyramid of Cholula is probably one of the most important ones. Did you know that it's considered the biggest one in the world, taking into account its space? I would like to tell you a bit of history about it.
I think that beauty is something very subjective, depending on your preference.
And we can continue with this and more examples, but I think you got the idea. It's like I have their contributions in this project, and then I can add these probably interjections, probably some other questions to make them go back to the project and continue with it. I think it's great because they are not expecting that, and they are pushed to think about what to say, what to answer. You can try that. Okay, teachers, let's move on to number two. Another activity, in this case, I would recommend you to have for advanced students is to create audio tutorials to make pasta, to build a piece of furniture, to discover a new trick on Fortnite. So you as a teacher assess their attention to detail when they are producing. You also assess the correct structures in order to send the right message, pronunciation, intonation, stress, and so many other elements that you consider in your evaluation criteria. What about number three? Complete the sentences. Record incomplete sentences so your students use their creativity. For example, you can say, last night I needed a glass of water. I went to the kitchen and then there is a big silence. They have to complete it. Let's take this same example to the next level. What if their answers are sounds? What if a student completes the sentence with exaggerated sounds and another one decodes those sounds? Here's my example. Okay, I say, last night I needed a glass of water. I went to the kitchen and then, ouch! Did you catch that? So there's going to be like somebody else's responsibility to put those sounds into words. I think that's something that can explode your students' minds. And of course, creativity can have like a bit the main role recording these audios, okay? Number four, interviews. Your students ask questions about certain topics to their parents. Have you considered that? Brothers and sisters and their teachers from the online school. They can be in Spanish or they can be in their mother tongue, of course. Then encourage them to translate. I know some of you won't agree on this. It's all right. But I'm telling you this because I've seen some TV anchors who try their best to interview native speakers in their shows. Students don't have to do it simultaneously. They can prepare it in English and record their interpretations later. Parents will get involved as well as teachers from other subjects. This is so valuable, teachers, if you think about all the possibilities you can create. And of course, there's evidence, actual evidence of doing something, being committed to something, and of course, having parents' participation. Number five, assign them to listen to a particular podcast. For instance, I said the BBC ones, and I suggested you, and then asked them what they think about, their thoughts about the story, about what they understood, what they liked or they didn't like, but now following an order. That means that they will follow a sequence to participate and give their opinions of other students' contribution to the podcast. So if somebody listens to the podcast first, and then the other person or the other student has to listen to that, continue, or like adding extra comments to what a student or a partner said before, and then add their contributions. Don't you think that's a great idea? Well, if not, no problems. I got another one. This next activity is related to the previous one. So do you think you can't find tailor-made material for that particular lesson of the book, of your book, teacher? No problem. It's your turn to be a podcaster, and your students will be your audience. Create the episodes and ask them to follow you. I'm sure you'll feel more confident of recording yourself. That, sooner or later, you can start making your own program outside your classroom. Again, teacher, consider all the good things that can happen after this. Number seven, create a soap opera. You can be the narrator of the story and guide your students with situations that encourage them to use certain structures or vocabulary of the current lesson. They'll create the dialogues. You can ask them to build their characters with certain characteristics, to use specific vocabulary, to avoid word repetition. So they look for synonyms instead. Think about the possibilities. I'll leave a link with free royalty-free sounds, background sounds, sorry, so you can use. Okay. Number eight. Audio lessons. But when I say this, it's like you teaching and you being recorded for this. And now you file, and the topic can be the one you decide, of course. You can fake your voice in order to create examples or to make examples for your students, fake your accent, or simply ask other teachers to help you to explain the same topic. This can be saved and used for further classes. Imagine that. Imagine where your students listening to other teachers, I don't know, probably from the past or the ones that got a reputation at school. And you say, okay, that's not my everyday teacher. It's another one. It's Professor Carlos, Martin, et cetera, et cetera. Okay, that's not all, folks. I have more activities for you. Okay, so this one, active collaboration. You say, yo, Hernán, you said a minute ago that it was like collaboratively doing this, but let me tell you that there's another thing here. Speaking about collaboration, why don't you allow more advanced students to help you record some audios for a podcast, and your intermediates and beginners can listen to them? Later in class, they can offer you their opinions, thoughts, and questions. They can easily get used to your tone of voice, your accent, and your style. But using these audios with new people, I'm sure it can be a challenge and a fresh air for them as well. Okay. Number 10, shadowing. I'm sure that you have heard about this technique. Take chunks of audio materials and ask students to record themselves over the original audio. They have to imitate the pronunciation and the pace for this. It is worth once you notice some students can also add their own style to the recording. This can be a fun activity to have, not just for them, but for you. Number 11. Start your karaoke. Can your students complete a song together? What if you, as a teacher, sing the first lines of a popular song and then ask your students to continue? What if you start with something like, "Here comes the sun," and then you leave it out? There is no audio after that. Your students will be required to complete it, to continue with the do-do-do-do, and so on and so forth. Picture that. I think it's a great activity. You will hear those, you know, deep voices out there, and then you will have the beautiful voices of girls. I don't know, you can think about it and just apply it. Now, music can be in the background, okay? But don't forget to respect the author by not publishing the audio online. Anchored and Soundtrap allow you to have the audios on your own, so you don't spread them, and you know, people that you don't wish to see it are part of it. Okay. Okay. So we are about to finish with this. I know you are tired. So many activities so far, but I have more. Believe me. Number 12. Keep an oral diary. This means students can record their thoughts and ideas in an independent file apart from others. It's just an audio between the student and the teacher. Be careful, if they are underage. I won't recommend you to do this with them, but with adults, you can have a couple of students that you think they get along well, and you're just there to monitor, okay? What about another one? You say, number 13, create a story with background sounds. Did you hear that? There was a bird outside my house. You can also add those sounds to your podcast. More advanced students can track the sounds you share with them as a project. They will develop stages of a story. Picture that. So only with sounds you create, they have to build a story. It doesn't have to be perfect, teacher. Believe me, they can produce real situations through sounds. Just to finish with this, there are so many activities that you can do, of course, and these are the ones I suggest, but how can we assess this? No worries. I'll leave some rubrics and paper research for you to choose depending on the activity you decide to try. The ones I found are pretty close to the criteria I usually use in my lessons. But don't forget, your criteria is the best because you are the one in charge of great students, but better people. All right. So thank you so much again. I think this is going to be like the end of the presentation. And once again, thank you all for coming. You don't know what I'm feeling right now, but believe me, my heart is bumping so hard. So over to you, Rosalina.
Thank you very much, Hernán. I'm sure all participants here today, and again, thank you very much for being with us here today, are very happy that we will be getting the link to be able to see this again, because we have lots of comments, people saying, thank you, great ideas. I want to start using them, those ideas, etc. Somebody had asked us to actually go to the first activity, and you did that while we were trying to make the screen work again. And somebody would like to see, you went to the slide where we can see Menti. So they wanted to see that. If you can just very quickly show them that one, and I will get you some of the very interesting questions we have.
What do you mean? Results?
Okay. Yes. That one. Okay, so I will ask for some questions. You said, when I introduced you, I said that you live in Puebla, and then we have this colleague of yours saying that Puebla is a very beautiful city. We have some people saying that their cities are also lovely. We agree with all of you. We have so many lovely cities in Mexico, in Latin America, all over the world. A very interesting question from Mayra. Do podcasts have a price?
Mm-hmm. No. These are absolutely for free, especially the ones that I'm sharing with you. These two are like absolutely for free. You will be delighted to know that Soundtrap was acquired by Spotify. So this is a way that Spotify is encouraging people to create their own podcast. So it's absolutely for free, and it has, you know, this big support from a huge company such as Spotify.
Okay. How about you talk about Anchor, and somebody saying, yes, I've got an iPhone. Is that a good combination, using my iPhone with Anchor?
Yeah, absolutely. In my experience, I have tested so many different types of devices. And believe me, this is just what I've experimented. iPhones got like these great microphones, and the audio is so clean that you can definitely use Anchor with your iOS device.
Okay. Sure. And somebody would like to know, but you yourself, Hernán, do you use Anchor?
Yes, I do. I do. In fact, because I do it to promote the YoTeAyudoTeacher YouTube channel and, of course, my podcast, I use it to post my audios, my files on Spotify, iTunes, iVox, the ones that I mentioned here. So they are available for all people that want to listen to them. Yes, of course.
Okay. Which one would you recommend for people who would like to start? Which is the easiest one to use?
Anchor. Anchor is the option. I mean, you are a way to create your podcast from some tabs. It's so intuitive and easy to manage. And that is the one. I mean, you only need your, as I said before, your smart device, an internet connection, download the app, and that's it. You continue with that.
Okay. You show different potential activities when using podcasts. Did you actually order them going from easiest to most challenging?
Well, to be honest, I just got brainstorming, and I just recall the ones that I use in my lessons. But I can do that. I mean, the file is there, and it's going to be there for all of you. So you decide the way that you can apply it. I just let it open because I understand teachers can have different perspectives and, of course, different levels in their classes. So sorry, I just moved that. And so they can adapt it. So, but I can do that, no worries.
Okay. I can upload them if I... This is what I would call a technical question because it shows my ignorance, of course. Can I use Soundtrap? Is it Soundtrap or Soundtrap in Chromebook?
Soundtrap.
Soundtrack. Soundtrack in Chromebook.
Yeah, yes. Yes, because as I said, there is a web version. So you just go there and surf the net with your browser. In this case, it's going to be Google Chrome. And then you open it and it works the same. Yeah.
And if you could remind us about the link for background sounds, please.
Oh, sure. Well, it is not just for that. I mean, it has all this material, videos and stuff. Everything is there. Let me just show you. So if you scan the code, you will see absolutely everything that you saw or that I shared with you.
And there's the QR code if you can be there for a little while, because some people would like to go right now, use that QR code right now. Thank you.
Yeah, please go there. And just one thing to say is that I'll upload this presentation in a moment. I mean, it's not there yet, but I'm about to upload it. But the rest of the files, the audios, and the links, because I prepared a set of links for you to start with podcast, it's there.
Okay. Interesting question. Can anyone listen to your podcast, or is it just available to the ones you invite to join?
Now we have to separate two things. I have like podcasts for my students. Those are private because I need to respect their privacy. But on the other hand, I have my own podcast, which is for English teachers. You must be surprised because it's in Spanish, because I started this idea in order to help my colleagues in my, well, in Latin America and of course other countries where they speak Spanish. But I'm considering to start making some in English because the answer or like the expectation is so big that I'm sure that all my content needs to be told in English as well. And of course, what you are checking on the screen right now are just the links to access to my podcast. So we have a link for iTunes, Spotify, my channel on YouTube, and of course, Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. You can find me there.
Okay. We have a question about this. Says a teacher who says, I love the ideas, but I'm thinking about some of my students who cannot really afford an iPhone, for example, or a mobile.
Mm-hmm.
What can I do with them? How can they use it?
Now, here's the thing. You can do this once we go back to our classrooms, and your device can be the one to record their audios. That's an option that I can offer you right now. Now, for the ones that are able to have or to have access to a cell phone, well, I think they won't find any problem at all. But believe me, you can also do that with your device. That's what I'm always doing when I'm teaching. Sometimes my students, for some reason, don't have a cell phone, can't afford one. So my cell phone is there available for them to play, because I display Kahoot in my classes as well. So that's my recommendation. They can do that, or they can ask their parents, or if they have a friend. I wouldn't say a friend because we need to be separated okay. Right now, but probably they have an older sister, older brother. So in that way, and they can send the teacher the audios, as I said before, like WhatsApp audios. And I have to say that we can have some issues because of the extensions of the files. Sometimes they don't match, but that would be like another webinar that we can talk about technical issues.
Okay. Somebody would like to know, have you ever had problems getting your students to start using this?
Oh, yeah. So many problems. And I think the main, the characteristic that share all of them is that they're scared. They are scared to just try this for once. And I assume that most teachers are struggling right now, or most of the teachers are struggling right now with technology. So I think that's the first obstacle, like being scared to try this, to listen to themselves. But once they are, clicking all the options that they have on the apps, they love it. And I have had such a good, great moments, I would say, it's great moments with my students once they overcome those obstacles.
That's
but no
great.
Worries. Believe me, the apps
and
are absolutely intuitive.
We have a colleague here who's saying, Gabriela, thank you. Maybe it would be better. We can start using this as a resource for ourselves, the educators,
And
then move to our students, which sounds great.
Yeah. And now that you mentioned this, I have links for you teachers to start listening to podcasts. Believe me, there are many, many options out there for us, specifically for us. If we are aware that podcasts are there for teaching you English as well, but there are great resources for us as teachers, like with great advice and many recommendations. So those links are also there if you scan the code that is on the screen.
Good, because some people have asked, we have had hundreds of people saying great, wonderful ideas. Thank you very much, Hernán. We can tell that you're a very creative person. To all the people who are asking to see different slides, you will have the link so you can see everything again at your own pace and check, etc.
Exactly.
A question, how can we have a private podcast?
The way I show you at the beginning of the presentation with Anchor, in fact, with both of them, it says that you can publish it. Once you have all the audios and segments together with Anchor, you publish it and it's going to be there. So you can share your URL address just for your students so they can listen to it. It's going to be even more private if you don't publish it, but you share with your students the projects, they add their contributions, and of course they have to have the application. That's the way
okay.
It can be like private.
Thank you very much. Hernán, this has been great. We're going to show you one last slide, and this is not part of your PPT, Hernán, but just a huge reminder for everyone. Hernán, thank you very much for accepting our invitation to share this with you. You can see, you have now seen for yourselves what I mean when I say a very creative person, a really wonderful colleague that I have met. So thank you very much. And if you are, we know that we have had people from Ecuador, from Central America, from Latin America, all sorts of different places. We have lots of things for you. And here you will see some of the links that you can use to find out. Some countries celebrate Teachers' Day at different times of the year. In Mexico, we're very happy that May the 15th is Teachers' Day. Let me tell you, for us at Cambridge English, and remember, at Cambridge, we really care about what has been happening. You are being heroes, and we really want to celebrate with you, not just May the 15th, not just this week, the whole month and the whole time. You are great. Please, your certificates will be arriving soon. Our very creative marketing colleagues have just told me that you shouldn't have to wait longer than 24 hours to get the links, the certificate, everything that you need. We expect to see you at some of the other events we have. We have lots of things we've been creating and repurposing, lots of different resources. Thank you very much, Hernán. Thanks to everyone. Please keep safe, and I'm sure we will see you again somehow. Bye-bye.
Thank you. Bye-bye.